Variables in Figma were released last year, but from what I can see, they've mostly been used in design systems. Here, I'm going to show you how to use variables when making Figma prototypes. This will let you make simpler, sleeker prototypes with way less component clutter, way fewer variants. We're going to be making this. It's a fairly complex sidebar component, and it's got different bits that kind of move around. And I've left a starting file in the description, so if you duplicate that, you'll be able to follow along with me as we make this. Variables are your ticket to efficiency, so by making sure you know how to use them, you'll soon become a Figma expert. So let's get started, and just before we jump into it, let me say, hey, I'm Parvin. I'm a designer and design educator, and I teach people how to become better at design. If that sounds like something you're interested in, do hit subscribe so you don't miss any new videos. So this is the starter file that you'll be able to copy, and you can see it's all set up with auto layout frames for each of these menu options. And we've got some components over here. So a component for the tag, components for icons, and then for these little status tags. And over here, I've got an example of what it would look like when this wellness section is closed and other apps are open. And just again to explain what the idea here is that you could toggle on physical or mental and the right ones would show up. So lots and lots of things to do here. We want to make sure that scrolling is maintained. So if this other app section expands, that we can still scroll up to here, nothing gets cut off. And I'm going to show you how to do all of this with just one component. So we'll start by going up to local variables and we'll create our first variable, which will be a Boolean. And we'll call this wellness. And this is just gonna show whether this is open or closed. We're gonna do that a few more times for physical, mental, and other apps. So what we're using here is we're using variables to track the state of something. So instead of doing component variants like you might have done before, we're gonna do all of this with variables. And it's actually really, really easy. So what we'll do is we'll start by doing wellness. So let's put all of this stuff into one frame. So I'm going to select all of it and do Command Option G, and then that has appeared in a frame. Just call that wellness dropdown. And this is the bit which is a bit confusing, but over here with layer, what you can see is this eye toggle. That's what we want to turn on and off. But we want this to be controlled by one of the variables. So the way we do that is we hold down Control. And as we hold on Control, we'll see a list of these variables here. And we're going to just click wellness. And now you'll see when we toggle the wellness variable on and off, the visibility of that layer changes. So this is what we're going to use to drive this whole menu bar. Now you'll see there's some things which I've missed off here. We want this to change as wellness gets turned on and we want it all to stack together. So to get it all to stack together, we're just going to put all of that in an auto layout frame. So grabbing all of that, Shift A to put it in an auto layout frame, and I'm just going to call that top. And then these can be in a section called bottom. And then for the whole sidebar, you can see that's a normal frame. We'll put that all in an auto layout frame. And instead of that being 126, we're just going to double click so that it becomes space between. So now no matter what height this is always pushed to the bottom. So if we turn off wellness now, you can see that stays at the bottom. If we didn't have that, it would just stay kind of halfway there. I'm also going to update that to be 20, so it's nice and neat. Now, to make the section click and open when we have this, what we're going to do is we're going to pull these two bits out into their own component. So selecting wellness and wellness dropdown, I'm just going to click up here and do create component, and then Command D to duplicate that. And I'm going to take the main component off the canvas. So here we've just got an instance of it, as you can see here. And I'm going to call this wellness. And what I'm going to do is create a variant. So this button up here goes to add variant. And in this one, I'm just going to get rid of all of the stuff inside. So wellness dropdown, just delete it. And press this button up here to resize the frame. So it's just this size. And we're going to call this one closed. Or actually what we'll do is we'll change the property to be open and set this one to be false and this one to be true. The reason I do that instead of having property one open or closed is because now when we go to the instance, by using true and false, we get a little toggle over here. So the last thing to do is to flip that around. So just clicking onto the icon and Shift B to spin it around. I'm just gonna tidy up my main component here. So now we've got wellness collapsed and open. And to make it go between these, instead of doing what you might normally do in prototype mode to connect to two variants and on-click change the variant, what we're going to do, I'll get rid of that. What we're going to do instead is add an interaction to set a variable to a state. So at this point, you'll come up into advanced prototyping, so you'll have to make sure you're on a paid team. If you're a student, you can get this for free by using Figma's education plan. I'm just going to move this into a paid team quickly. So now we can add an interaction to set a variable, and the variable we want to set is wellness. And so on click, we want it to become the opposite. So if it's open, we want it to become closed. If it's closed, we want it to become open. So the way we do that is we change variable wellness to be not variable wellness. Now that sounds super confusing. If you know any coding, it's like putting an exclamation mark before something, but if you don't worry about it. That's all you need to know how to do. So set variable wellness to not wellness. We'll do the same for this top bar up here. Interactions, on click, set variable wellness to be not wellness. Now we're just gonna have a quick preview. So I'm gonna click on my sidebar, shift space to open it up in prototype mode. And now you'll see that it has not worked. So the reason this hasn't worked is because we don't have auto layout resizing this option. So if I come back to my canvas, set that variable to false, you'll see that the wellness box is still taking up that space. So that's a really simple fix. All we have to do is come over to this variant in the wellness component, add auto layout to that so that it can set to hug, and you'll see straight away that that has now collapsed. So now turning that on and off will show and hide those things. And doing it in our prototype, we can see that it is closing and opening properly. Now you can see we're still not got this perfectly. We're not switching between the variants. All we're doing now is we've got a prototype link to set the variable on and off. What we need to do is link each variant to the variable. That's a bit of a mouthful. Link each variant to the variable. And again, this is super simple to do, but it's a bit hidden, kind of like that eye icon. So the way to do this is to go to our instance on the canvas, and you'll see once we've double clicked into it, we've got it here, and that will open and close it. So let me turn this back on so we can see it opening and closing. And that is the functionality that we want to happen. So we're just going to link this instance property to the variable. So you see this icon has appeared now, assign variable, and we're going to match that to wellness. So now instead of manually controlling that toggle, it's just connected to the variable. So now in our prototype, that is behaving exactly as we'd expect. By the way, if you've got any questions with anything or you think I'm going too fast, just drop me a comment below and I'll make sure I get back to you. So the next thing to set up is making all of these toggles work. So the first thing we need to do is add a variant to our tag for when it is off. So again, we're going to do the same thing and use a true false property. So shown true, shown false. And we'll just change that fill to something a bit more like, it looks like it's off. And we're not going to touch these, we're not going to do any prototyping between these two variants, because again, we're going to drive everything by variables. And again, this is really, really easy to do. All we have to do is select the options in here, which are linked to physical. So let's pick those ones, maybe not yoga. And down here in our layer part of the side panel, we just hold down control and click on the eye icon and select physical. And same for the other three, we select mental. And again, with these, we can use the instance swap. So shown, we're gonna link that to mental and that one to physical. So now when we turn those on and off, we get the right things appearing. Then all we need to do is add auto layout so these stack properly. So we'll come back to our main component and we'll see here that this is just a normal frame. So all we have to do is add auto layout. And while I'm here, that has added a wrap auto layout, and we just want a down auto layout and to put those two in a horizontal. So grabbing both of those, shift A, and I'm gonna rename that to tags. And what we'll do is we'll indent the whole thing a little bit just so it feels like it's under that wellness option, and push that down so it's a bit neater. And now coming back over here, we can see that those toggles are working correctly. So the very last thing we need to do is on these toggles, we need to go to prototype mode and do interaction, set variable, and we're going to do the same thing again. So set physical to be not physical, and for mental, we're going to set mental to be not mental. So what just happened for me is it glitched a bit. So after setting those, if it isn't working for you, just unlink it and relink it here. But now it's working, and with a bit of trial and error, hopefully this will work for you as well. So now we've got physical and mental filtering properly, we've got this wellness section collapsing, and we've got auto layout working properly. So the last part is to make this other app section expand and collapse so we can see some other apps. So this is an example of what we want it to look like. So I'm going to do this in a really similar way. If you've been following along, I really encourage you to stop watching this recording now and have a go at doing this yourself. It's very similar to the wellness bit over here, so see if you can work out how to do it. So what we're going to do is we're going to grab this other apps row, Command Option K to make it a main component, Command D to duplicate it, and then we'll just take the main component off the canvas. I'm going to make another variant here, so drag a copy of this off, Command Option B to unlink it, and then I've got my little frame over here called apps, and I'm just going to grab those two, put them together, flip that icon around using Shift V, and then call that apps like that, Command Option K to make that a new main component, and grab the two of them and do combine as variants. If you didn't follow all of that, I really recommend you going to check out my video about component variants and just try and follow those steps along with me. Using Figma shortcuts is really, really useful. You can see how quickly I can do things in Figma because I'm so familiar with these shortcuts. So slow down the video, watch that again if you need to. But now we've got an apps component which has two variants. We're just going to label these up properly, so calling that shown, false, call this one shown, set that to true. And now, as you remember, we've got our other apps variable, so we just need to connect those up to the variable. So just like we did last time, we're going to connect the variant to other apps here, and we're going to set variables using the prototype mode, so interactions, set variable, other apps, not other apps. And one more time for this one, interactions, set variable, other apps, not other apps. So now just to test it, if we open up our variables panel, toggling that on and off expands and collapses that section, and we can see it in prototype mode as well. Clicking on that opens and closes it. So now we've got our app sidebar, and hopefully you followed along how to do all of that. The very last thing I'm just going to talk through is scrolling. So if I make this frame a lot smaller, what we want is for this section to scroll and this section to stay fixed at the bottom. So the way to do that is here on bottom, I'm just going to make sure we've got a background on that so that when this is expanded, you can't see over it. And on the top section, we're going to go to prototype mode and do overflow vertical scroll. For the top section here, I'm going to change that from hug contents, which will make it the height of all the content, to fill container. So now you can see it's getting cut off. It's just taking up as much space as it can. So now our vertical scrolling will work. If we have that just set to hug, we'll get a notification here on overflow. The vertical scrolling won't work because the content needs to be bigger than the frame it's in. So set that to fill container, and you'll see we've got some scrolling here. Obviously, this doesn't look amazing because our bottom frame isn't going to the edges. So the way to fix that is to take the padding off of those frames and put the padding on the inside frames. So if we put that back to 20, 20, 12 there, 12, 20, and actually for the bottom, we can do 30, 20 to give it a bit more space up at the top, or 20, 10. And we'll give it a top stroke as well. Make that a nice subtle gray. So now you can see that if this was a much smaller navbar, that we would be able to scroll. And actually, a nicer way of doing this is to not even put the padding on this top frame, but put the padding inside. So now we've got the padding on this title section. We can do 20, 10. And now if we set this top header bit to sticky instead of scrolling with parent, you can see the main title stays at the top. What we'll just need to do is give that a fill of white, so, and change the top to canvas stacking where first is on top. So as we expand and collapse things, even though there's less room, we can scroll to see all of it, and it all behaves exactly as you'd expect. There's no scrolling when things are collapsed, but when we open them, we get the right amount of scrolling to be able to see all the items that we need to see. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video at all useful for upping your Figma game, please do share it with a friend or a colleague who you think it would be useful for. As I grow this channel and make more videos for designers, it would really help me out if you could leave a comment with what you'd want to see next, or maybe like and share the video as well, and please do hit subscribe as well. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you on the next one. Cheers.